provider of cosplay Freddy, aka Freddy Jones III, representing Grim Ones Productions, and I have the awesome opportunity to interview Mr. and Mrs. Kenneth Sean Tate Daniels, aka Cosplay Royalty. So, we got our introductions out of the way, but let the people know who you all are.
Well, I'm Sean Tate. Of course, you guys know that. Sorry, I lost my voice a little bit, but I'm the wife of Black Panther Cosplay Royalty.
Kenneth Daniels, Kate of Cosplay.
I'm a Shay.
We've been cosplaying for many years.
Yeah.
Been married for a year now.
A
year and a half. Been together for like 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
We just been
here.
We're really excited.
We're excited to be here with him. We're very excited to be here with Freddie. He's our friend. We love him to death. He's talented. Like works extra hard at everything that he does. We've been in videos with him. We've done a film with him. You know what I mean? So it's like we're just amazed to be here right now. You know what I mean? We're going to talk about some very important things.
Okay, cool. Well, thank you for that shout out. I do appreciate it. Y'all, you know, every time we all are together, you know, it's whether it's a con. Yeah, definitely. It's a con. It's a film project, or you know, obviously. Graduation party, so you know, you gotta eat some nice home cooked meals with moms and pops and stuff like that. Oh, speaking of which, moms and pops come to tell you, hey,
really?
I told them I'll come out here
to have them. Because I was like, love them.
Yeah.
I hope they like them.
Yeah. Oh, no. They was like, make sure you come late when you get out there.
Well, we appreciate you.
But I really just embrace my country life. You know what I mean?
I was born in Oakland.
Okay.
But my family came from Arkansas.
I had
a lot of family. Like my grandmother, she's from Arkansas. And she came out here in the 80s.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And ever since then, I've been in Oakland and we moved out here in the Vallejo area around that.
Well, I can say what got me into cosplay was him today. When we first started dating, he was like, yeah, I can really do this. And I've always been an artist.
Okay.
You know what I mean? But I've never really been in like costumes and things like that. So he was just like, yeah, I go to these events. You know, I mean, I'm 500 miles at that time. Now we're like 6 years ago. You know what I mean? So I was like, what? You know what I mean? And then he wanted to do graphic. So I was like, but he got me into it, you know, all around, because I wouldn't be as great as I am right now if he didn't give me up, and he lifted me up every step of the way. He watches me literally struggle to build everything I build. He's there all the time, so I have to keep going. That's what got me into it.
Well, I actually started going a while back. It was really like in 2005 when I used to go to WonderCon.
Okay.
Went back today with the first one.
Okay.
And I didn't just go in as attendee, you know, I didn't cosplay. I did that for like 2 years. And one of the days, with me and my friend, I was with him at the time. He was like, yeah, man, something happened at work. It was breakfast.
Right.
And he's like, hey, man, we need to go to a big school. I'm like, okay, where? Because I had an old Miles Morales suit I had for Halloween.
Okay.
And this is before I did Craven or anything. I had Miles Morales suit now. We went to Anaheim, WonderCon.
Okay.
That was the first time I cosplayed was Anaheim. And that was like 2004.
Okay.
2011.
Oh, wow.
And I've been doing ever since then.
we grew up with these people. Yeah. You know what I mean? We grew up with these characters. It's so important.
Yeah, it's been doing ever since then. And I have no plan, I think, to stop right now.
I don't think we really are going to stop. You know what I mean? We are able to keep going because we just love them. I feel like I can't never stop the character. I just feel like I have to continue. I have to continue because I have to change them. They change up our lives. You know what I mean?
Now, that's good that you all said that. And I noticed what I keep hearing with the narrative is representation because you brought up Miles Morales. You know, I brought up Calypso. Now, I remember Calypso. Now, listen, I'm about to date myself age-wise. I was honestly never really into comic books because I didn't like reading. I was always visual.
Right.
So, but like, if you can tell me a story, I can paint the story in my head. Right. So, my homeboy, Nicky Bond, shout out to Nicky Bond, he introduced me to the trading cards, the Marvel trading cards. And truth be told, I think I still have my Calypso cover.
Really?
Back in the walls. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, you remember what series it was?
I can paint it where it was a blue border and she had her suit on. It was almost like a shadowy, like a gray and black shadowy background, and she was like striking this pose above it.
Oh
yeah,
I know something about it. It's like 90s, it's like Marvel 90s.
I always do that quote in my pictures with her.
Yeah, so yeah. Like that. Always do that about actually, you know.
Yeah,
like
that's a real part too. Keep hold on.
Oh yeah,
you know, Raven was supposedly the Black Panther film before.
Before he was the Black Panther.
Before the Black Panther.
Oh, see, again, didn't know that, but that's the cool thing about like learning from folks who read about comic books. You know, it's like you learn something new every day. Now, that kind of segues me into the whole representation aspect of it. How do you all feel being, you know, a black cosplayer? How important is representation to you all? What's up with you?
When I think about it, it's really as, you know, I represent it, but not because he's a black character.
Right.
You know, it's more of I relate to the character.
Okay.
And him being black, it's just an even a better place.
Okay.
You know, so when people go out there and represent, like a lot of people go out there and want to represent the character because of breaking the barrier, breaking the trend. A lot of people want to break the trend, so they would do something out of ordinary just to be the first one and not have no real meaning.
Okay.
You know, and that's what when I did Miles Morales, that's what why I did, because Spider-Man's cool. And like, I mean, I love Spider-Man anyway. That's like one of my favorite superheroes. I relate to him. I can't relate to him like that. I can't relate to Superman Spider-Man.
Right.
I can't relate to Superman or Spider-Man to Admiral.
Okay.
You know, but that's what made me want to talk about this game. But representation is, you do the character for that, you should have a reason for that as well. And that shouldn't be to break the trend or try to be different.
Okay.
I guess everybody knows I do a lot of costumes.
Right.
But clearly that is 100%. I'm a little black girl, I'm Asian mixed, but I'm a little black girl, waking up Saturday morning, Monday morning, seeing Edmund come on and seeing this figure that represents everything a little black girl would want to be.
Right.
This Amazonian, beautiful black woman with this hair, like this people in Africa and things like that, with the white hair and blue eyes. That's real. So it was almost like this is for me. You know what I mean? And I took it to it like, I have to represent this woman. I have to. I take every prize, anything I do when I do a costume, I personally put all of my all in that. Because I feel like she stands for a lot. Like, I'm here. You know what I mean? Like, I'm in a time where everything goes like it.
Right.
And we have this woman who's Mother Nature.
Right.
And she's black. From
if I don't stand up for that, then I don't know what else to do. Like, tonight, if I all here, you know what I mean? Just kind of understand what you want, what you should, or what you're saying, anything that you love. But this is like, I mean, cosplay is just a way to just form yourself a little bit. Kind of just learn a lot about yourself.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Him, my husband, being Black Panther, to me, just as strong man. And he doesn't do Black Panther because he's popular.
Right.
He doesn't do Black Panther because he could beat Black Panther. He understands the red book. So it means the same thing to me as well. That's what it is.
Okay. All right, awesome. Well, I do appreciate those honest answers, and obviously our viewers do appreciate those honest answers. All right.
For right now.